Schönen guten Morgen, alle Guten. Ich bin Tom, der Prof von Luxemburgisch with Anne. Now, are you ready to practice your conversation skills with me? I hope so. And I hope that you enjoyed the conversation workout 1. And if you have missed that one, you can check it up later. I have put a link below this video. Now, today we will focus, so in this conversation workout, we will focus on making plans. And as the previous conversation workout, this is an intensive repeat after me style lesson. So you will practice some very similar questions, some very similar phrases. You will listen to me first and then you will try them yourself. This will help you to strengthen not only your speaking skills, but as well your listening skills. Now, making plans is something that we do every day. So we make plans for what is coming in the next future. We make plans for what is going to happen now in the next moment from now. And it is really awesome conversation practice because you propose ideas, you share opinions, and then you find a solution that everyone is happy with. So, warst du bereit für den Lektion, für dein Conversation Workout? Are you ready? Dann los! Process of making plans with someone almost always begins with asking a question. And in Luxembourgish, it is very common, it is very casual, it is very natural to start a conversation, especially with a friend, by asking this question. Wat willst du machen? Wat willst du machen? Now, in spoken and in natural Luxembourgish, you will hear instead of machen, man. Okay, so the question will sound like this. Wat willst du man? Wat willst du man? And remember what you have learned in the conversation workout 1, that in questions, we prefer to use the weak form of du, which is de. So the question would sound like this. Wat willst du man? Let's repeat. Wat willst du man? Wat willst du man? Or wat willst du da man? Wat willst du da man? Here you can hear that I have added the word done. And as done is subject to the N rule, sometimes you will just hear done. Now, done doesn't change anything to the sense of the question. It is just here to make the question sound more casual. Now, you will learn more about the word done as a modal particle in a next lesson on my blog. Okay, just let's repeat. Wat willst du da man? And now, if you want to ask these questions to several friends, you will say, wat will dir machen? Or wat will dir man? Wat will dir man? Wat will dir man? Now maybe you have noticed how I pronounced wilt dir. I pronounced it will dir. Will dir. Now it is very common in spoken Luxembourgish not to pronounce the final T of a verb when it is followed by dir. Wat will dir man? Wat will dir man? Great! Let's add some time marker to this question. For example, you can say, wat willst du den Abend man? Now listen and repeat. Wat willst du den Abend man? Wat willst du den Abend man? Or wat willst du denn man? Wat willst du denn man? Or when talking to several friends, you can ask, wat will dir de weekend man? Wat will dir de weekend man? Now you can as well use the word so. to start, for example, a conversation. So, so comes from the verb so, and usually it means to say. But if you say so to someone, this means tell me. So you can start your sentence with so. Was willst du den Abend machen? It sounds very casual. So, was willst du den Abend machen? And it helps as well to bring the focus to you. Okay, you can as well say Sod, wat will dir den Abend machen? So say Sod when you address this question to several people and so if you just are asking this question to one person. Okay, now let's add some suggestion to that question. So you can say to someone, so, wat willst du den Abend machen? Sollen wir etwas essen gehen? So, was willst du den Abend machen? Sollen wir etwas essen gehen? Or when talking to several people, Sod, was willst ihr den Weekend machen? Sollen wir anstatt etwas trinken gehen? Sod, was willst ihr den Weekend machen? Sollen wir anstatt etwas trinken gehen? Fantastic! When you are speaking with work colleagues or with customers, so in a more formal situation, you should use the more polite form of the same question. This is, wat wilt ihr gerne machen? And more natural would be, wat wilt ihr gerne machen? Let's repeat, wat wilt ihr gerne machen? Wat wilt ihr gerne machen? Great. Let's add again some time marker, so you can say, wat will dir gerne lo machen? Or more natural, wat will dir gerne lo machen? Wat will dir gerne lo machen? So you have heard that I didn't say lo, but lo. Again, in spoken Luxembourgish, it is very common to say lo instead of lo. Let's repeat. Wat will dir gerne lo machen? Or wat will dir gerne herno machen? Great. Okay, so this by adding this word gär, you sound much more polite. Or another way of inviting people to make plans, to ask them something is, wat hast du Lust zu machen? Or, wat hast du Lust zu machen? That's more natural. Wat hast du Lust zu machen? Wat hast du Lust zu machen? Or when talking to several friends, you would rather say, wat hu dir Lust zu machen? Wat hu dir Lust zu machen? Now listen and repeat after me. Wat hu dir Lust zu machen? Let's add again some time marker. Wat hu dir Lust mur zu machen? Wat hu dir Lust mur zu machen? Or, wat hust du Lust no der Abend zu machen? Wat hust du Lust no der Abend zu machen? Now, let's practice some answers to this question. Now, you can answer either by starting with Ösch hulost. Ösch hulost. Or by making a softer suggestion like Solema. Solema. Let's start with Ösch hulost. So, you can say Ösch hulost bei den Italiener essen zu gehen. Or Ich will Lust, Italienisch essen zu gehen. You can even add a pause while you are singing. This sounds more natural. Ich will Lust, Japanisch essen zu gehen. Okay? And now let's put some emphasis. You can as well say, Ich will richtig Lust auf Nudeln. Ich will richtig Lust auf Nudeln. Now here you have noticed when I say, Ich will Lust up, you don't need to use a verb in a second verb in your sentence. Huh? For example, you can as well say, schon richtig Lust auf Sushi. Okay. Now, if you want to make a softer suggestion, you can use sollen wir. For example, sollen wir bei den Italiener essen gehen? Sollen wir bei den Italiener essen gehen? So here again, in questions, we prefer to use the weak form. So here we use the weak form of mir, which is ma. And it sounds like this, ma. Let's repeat, ma. Great. Und ihr könnt sagen, sollen wir etwas anstatt trinken gehen? Sollen wir etwas anstatt trinken gehen? Great! Now let's head on to our answer, Schulosch. Just to invite the opinion of the people you are making plan with. For example, you can say, ich habe Lust, einen Film gucken zu gehen. Aber was willst du gerne machen? Now listen again carefully and try to find out what form of pronoun are used in the second part of the sentence. Ich habe Lust, einen Film gucken zu gehen. Aber was willst du gerne machen? Did you hear that I used the strong form of do and not the weak form the? Why? Well, because I just invite the other person to express his opinion and therefore I put emphasis here on the do. Let's repeat. Ich habe Lust, einen Film gucken zu gehen. Aber was willst du gerne gucken? Oder was willst du gerne machen? Great. Now, if you want to sound softer, to make your suggestion softer or more polite, you can say instead of ich habe Lust, ich hätte Lust. It sounds more polite. Ich hätte Lust, etwas trinken zu gehen. Und du? Ich hätte Lust, etwas trinken zu gehen. Und du? Or when talking to several people, you can say, also, ich hätte Lust, auf der Christmarkt zu gehen. Und dir? Let's repeat. Also, ich hätte Lust, auf der Christmarkt zu gehen. Und dir? Awesome work, great, and you did it until the end. I am delighted. And here take my learning tip. Now I did not do this lesson for you to watch it once and then to walk away and to forget about it. No. This is your workout, your training, all right? So I'll invite you to watch this video again and again, to listen and to practice with me. Because if you want to sound more natural, you have to get comfortable by using these questions, these phrases native speakers use, and as well to use these filler words like done or the weak forms of the pronouns in questions. All right? Great. And I want, so this is my objective, to make more conversation workouts like that one. But now I invite you to put in the comments below this video what kind of conversations you would like to practice. Okay, so then I will try to make such conversation workouts for you. Merci fürs Zugucken. Thank you for watching. Bis nächstes Mal. Adi.